It's a little ironic that Dr. Seuss's sleep book keeps me up at night. There's a part in here about a creature called the Chippendale Mupp. He bites his tail before he goes to bed because, and I quote, his tail is so long he won't feel any pain till the nip makes the trip and gets up to his brain. In exactly 8 hours, the Chippendale Mupp will at last feel the bite and yell, ouch, and wake up. And every time I read this, I think to myself, man, 8 hours seems like a really long time for the brain to feel pain. Interestingly, different sensations travel different speeds in different types of nerves. Acute pain, for instance, like a bite, is carried along A-delta fibers at speeds anywhere from 5 to 35 meters per second. So let's stick with the slowest possible of those speeds, 5 meters per second, and that should get us the shortest possible tail. 5 meters per second, by the way, is about 4 times as fast as a typical person walks. So we can take the equation for speed and rearrange it to solve instead for distance. We'll convert meters to feet, because America, convert hours to seconds so all the units can cancel out. Once we do the math, that gets us a tail that's about 472,000 feet long. That's like 89.5 miles. Now, that can't be right. I mean, Dr. Seuss shows us the entire tail on this page. There's no way that tail is 90 miles long unless a Chippendale Mupp is actually really big. Now, this isn't as crazy as it sounds. There's actually a precedent for scales of existence in the Seuss expanded universe. Remember, in Horton Hears a Who, there's an entire Who civilization floating around on a speck of dust trying to avoid genocide. That's right. Whos are tiny. Think of that the next time you read How the Grinch Stole Christmas. So if the tail actually is 89.5 miles long, then we can actually use the tail to establish scale in this picture. So I've got some string here, and I went ahead and I traced it along the tail in this picture, cut it out, and it ended up being about 45.5 inches long. That makes every inch of the string almost exactly 2 miles. The Chippendale Mupp is about 6 inches long, and so if he stood up, he would be 12 miles tall. That's 63,000 feet. To keep that in perspective, Mount Everest would barely come up to his belly button. Interestingly, the only thing I found at 63,000 feet is something called the Armstrong Limit. See, the higher you go, the lower the atmospheric pressure gets. As atmospheric pressure decreases, it becomes easier and easier for water to boil since there's less of a force keeping the water molecules together as a liquid. Well, at 63,000 feet, the Armstrong Limit, the air pressure is so low that any exposed body fluids will literally boil away at ambient temperatures. In 1965, a NASA test subject was accidentally exposed to near vacuum, and before he passed out, his last memory was of the water on his tongue starting to boil away. Well, with that gruesome thought, I actually think I have enough information to rewrite this passage. Standing 12 miles tall with a 90-mile tail, the life of a Mupp is a cautionary tale. He lays with his head in a bed of cool soil, for if he ever stood up, his tears would all boil. Now wait just a minute. I think I'm seeing another problem here. It's the trees, the trees. I'm speaking of the trees.
I speak for the trees.
Trees living their absolute best life would struggle to get to a height of about 500 feet because surface tension is needed to pull the water to the top of the trees, and that has real physical limits. So we have to really kind of abandon the idea that 1 inch on this page is 2 miles. That's way too big. If this tree is only 500 feet, that means 1 inch is actually only 250 feet. That drops the length of the tail to only about 2.2 miles. That also means if a Chippendale Mupp were to stand up, it would be at a much more respectable 1,500 feet, well below some of the tallest human structures. But this also means that we have radically overestimated the nerve speed of a Chippendale Mupp. If pain is traveling 2 miles in 8 hours, that means it's moving a pokey 0.12 meters per second. That's glacially slow. That would be like me hitting my thumb with a hammer and then not realizing it for like 4 seconds. Oh, God. You know, maybe this passage should really read, sure, a Chippendale Mupp is a gigantic creature, but lackadaisical nerves are its most notable feature. Why, it'll take half an hour before he'll start to understand that my grand band in demand just ran over his hand. So which fix was better, rhyme one or rhyme two? Into the comments go comments from you. But since you're still here, hit that button for me and raise my subscribers to 6,003.
Well, it's time for me now to turn out my light. Stay safe, stay out of trouble, and have a good night.